So we're going to start out with 1 1/2 cups of sugar. So it'll be 3 scoops of this. And 1 1/2 sticks of margarine. This recipe is a 70s recipe, so it's going to call for margarine, okay? I'm actually, instead of making the recipe, the original recipe, I'm actually making it a recipe and a half for the cake because it didn't call for enough flour, in my opinion, to fill up the cake pan good. So this is the butter and the sugar. We're going to cream it first. We're going to put in 6 eggs. Okay, so we're going to start with 6 eggs. There's 1. We're going to use a whole container of Hershey's syrup, 24 ounces, y'all. So, I think I'm going to put in half of it and then put in some flour and then put in the rest of the syrup. Okay? So, for the flour, it's self-rising flour and it's going to be 1 1/2 cups. Let me turn this thing. Well, that's as low as it'll go. I gotta be careful and not splatter this everywhere. It's got this paddle in it that likes to throw the flour out. That has the silicone on it. That's just what it does. There's 1 1/2 cups of flour, y'all. And let's put in the rest of this syrup. Is that chocolatey enough for you? A whole container. And I also add sugar. It's going to be really good and sweet and delicious, I hope. All right, and now we're going to put in a little bit of vanilla. 2 teaspoons of vanilla. This is 1 tablespoon of a 1/2 tablespoon. So this is what I'm putting in, but if you make it at home and you don't have one of these, because this is flavoring, just use 1 teaspoon of extract or 2 teaspoons of flavoring, okay? So there we got it. Simple dimple, right? That was so easy. And we really don't even have a big mess. Okay. So we're going to turn it off. It has mixed enough. We'll pour this in there. Then we're going to start making some icing for it, okay? So there's our delicious cake mix. It's kind of pretty runny, but it's got a whole thing of that syrup in there. So let's get it in here. We're going to bake it and see what happens. Okay, so I've got my oven preheated at 350, so we're going to place it in the oven. In the center, rack in the middle. Some evaporated milks actually have a pull top now with a pour spout. It's really nice. But these that I bought don't. Let me turn this down to medium. I'm going to turn this down to medium, and then we're going to add in our milk. I guess I better put this on low. All right, so we're going to do 2/3 cup of milk. I didn't punch the other side so it can breathe. This is our stick of margarine. We're going to add our cream and let that be heating up. Then we're going to get out our chocolate chips. And that would be 1/2 bag of chocolate chips. But since we're not using, I want to mix them 1/2 and 1/2, y'all. So I'm just going to put in some chocolate chips. It's going to be that simple for me. Y'all can measure it if you want to. That's the milk chocolate ones. And these are the mini semi-sweet ones, okay? Put on a little extra of those. All right, now sugar. And that's it. That's all there is to it. So our sugar is going to be 1.5 cups. Again. There's a half. That's 1 cup. I'm going to empty my container, y'all, it looks like. A little to grow on, right? Okay. So we're going to let that mix up to melt together. It's really like making fudge. So we're going to bring this, and you don't want to do it really fast. So we're going to bring this up to a boil. Once it starts to boil, then we can increase the temperature a little, put a lid on it. If you put a lid on it, it'll keep it, hopefully, from so much sugar to be on the side of the pan to turning it back to sugar. Because you know, when you make fudge, you can't get any sugar granules back into the fudge after it cooks, or it just turns to sugar. And when you bite into it, it tastes like sugar granules. I've got it. Oh, here's my lid. I'll use this lid since y'all are watching, and it won't be so boring. But now it's starting to bubble. It's going to start bubbling around the edges first. And you can hear it. I guess y'all can hear. I don't know if y'all can hear that or not, but it's starting to bubble. So we're going to put a lid on it for a minute. But once it starts boiling like this, you're going to want to go around the sides of the bowl. All right, let me get a wet, some water, and we're going to see if we can't get some of the fudge off the sides. It's already getting pretty doggone hot, too. Let me get me something to check it with. Let's check it. I'm going to check it before I fix the sides because I think it's already getting close. Now, I'm going to show y'all how to do this. Let me zoom y'all in a little bit so y'all can see how I check it. You take some water like this in a container, and then you just drop it in there. And if it falls to the bottom and it actually forms, look, y'all, it's actually formed into like little droplet circles. It's ready. It's really ready. It's at a softball stage. We'll do it again. If you can actually see it go down in that bottle and keep its circular shape, then it's at a softball stage. So I'm going to take this chopstick and we're going to punch some holes in here. It took this cake a while to get done. I would say a good 40, 45 minutes. I actually turned my oven down to 325 because when you're cooking chocolate cake, you don't want it to get too dark around the edges, okay? So if it's going to take a little longer to cook it, and we had a lot of batter in here, and it made a beautiful layer. I know I'm going to love this cake recipe. So I may even make this cake recipe to, like, do my chocolate cakes for birthdays and stuff because I think it's going to be amazing, okay? So we're going to pour our icing on here. It looks just like chocolate fudge, hot fudge, and we made it homemade. Looks good, don't it? It looks, I mean, y'all, it is amazingly beautiful and shiny and just perfectly creamy. come off of there. I didn't cut it good on the bottom.